Ever since I've started using Obsidian, I have tried many different plugins, and these are the 12 plugins that I still have installed and use pretty much on a daily basis, in alphabetical order. Calendar by Liam Kane is one of the most well-known and most installed plugins in Obsidian. Calendar works closely together with Daily Notes. You can create Daily Notes by clicking on a date and easily search for previous days, months, or even years by navigating through the little widget that it creates in your sidebar. You can add the days of the week as well. The only thing that I don't love is that it gives you these dots per day based on how many words you write in your Daily Notes on that day. I have since remedied that by making the threshold per dot really high. I think I made the threshold like 5,000 words or something, much higher than I usually write in my daily notes. So now every single daily note just looks like a single dot, and that is just what I prefer. I also noticed that this plugin hasn't been updated in a while. However, it still works great, at least on my Mac. Haven't had any problems with it, so let's hope it stays that way, since it's one of the most downloaded and one of my most used plugins in Obsidian. The next plugin is Chord Sheets. It's a very niche plugin, but I think that's what's so special about Obsidian. There truly is a plugin for everything. I use Chord Sheets for my guitar tabs. If you create a code block and add the right command to it, it makes it way easier to format chord sheets with lyrics and a chord above it. You can transpose, kind of like what you see on Ultimate Guitar, but without annoying premium locked features, pop-up videos, or chords that randomly disappear because of licensing issues. It also has another wonderful feature, which is auto-scroll. I love this feature because when you're like playing the guitar, you don't want to constantly have to stop and scroll down because you'll get out of time, mess up in the middle of a song. It's just not great. Auto-scroll is a lifesaver. I love it. Footnote Shortcut is a plugin that lets you add footnotes really easily by letting you add them as a hotkey. I have mine set as Command A, and it will automatically add a small one and move your cursor to the bottom of the page, setting you in completely the right place so you can just copy paste a link or add a citation in whatever way you want or are required if you're in university. Citation is a pain, I know. It's really simple, really only has one single use, but a really great one. It lets you change the name of the footnote heading and settings if you so desire, and yeah, it just streamlines your footnote experience a bit. As the name suggests, Hider is a plugin that lets you hide features in the user interface that you don't use and don't want to see. You can use it to hide a ton of different things, but I mainly use it to hide my vault name and to hide the toggle buttons on the sidebars, because I prefer to always have my sidebars visible anyway. I never collapse them. It's honestly a great way to unclutter, or declutter, I should say, your user interface from things you don't need. These UI elements can also be bound to a hotkey, so if you want some things to be easily switched on and off, you can do that as well. Homepage is one of my most used plugins. Homepage lets you open a specific note, canvas, or workspace upon launching Obsidian. My homepage is a list of indexes or maps of content so that I can easily navigate to anywhere in my vault just by clicking. I spoke at length about my preference for using indexes over using a large folder structure in my previous video, if you're curious about that. And the reason I like homepage so much is that I have it set up to automatically open if I don't have any other notes open. So whenever I click the last note away, it will automatically open homepage again, and I just prefer to have it in front of my face at all times. It also adds an icon to your ribbon menu on the left for easy navigation, and if you use the Obsidian mobile app, you can even set up a separate mobile page if you so desire. You can also set up a hotkey to open the homepage at any time if you prefer doing it that way. Natural Language Dates is another plugin that I use for a very specific purpose, and that is to add the current time using a hotkey. I like to write short entries in my daily notes in a bulleted format, kind of like interstitial journaling or rapid logging in a bullet journal format. And I used a natural language plugin to quickly add the time at the beginning of each bullet point so I know when I wrote a specific entry. This plugin makes it so I don't have to write the time manually each time, which just saves me time and creates a little less of a hurdle for journaling, dumping thoughts, anything really. It also allows you to auto-suggest using any character, and it will automatically add the dates, allowing you to cross-link between daily notes without having to type out the dates. It's such a small thing, but it makes working in daily notes so much more frictionless, and I love that. Omnivore is a free open source reading app that I use for reading articles and newsletters. It's not perfect, in my opinion. It's not as good as Readwise. You can tell the app is a lot less mature. However, Readwise is way too expensive and Omnivore is free, so I am willing to put up with its quirks. So what I do is I copy articles into the Omnivore app, or I use the browser extension, and then I read them and I highlight them, and then I sync them to Obsidian using the Omnivore plugin. This does not go completely seamless. Like I said, the app does have some quirks. For example, after reading and syncing an article, I usually have to delete the article from Omnivore, because otherwise you will end up with duplicates the next time you sync, which isn't great. But I'm willing to put up with that because, like I said, it's free, and I love being able to read articles whenever I want in a distraction-free location and being able to highlight stuff. Paste Image Rename is a very simple plugin. It's all in the name, really. Paste Image Rename creates a pop-up whenever you drag an image or another attachment into Obsidian, and it allows you to quickly rename something. I really like this because I often take a lot of quick screen grabs, and I don't want to end up with 1,000 files that are called screen grab 1043 or whatever. It also allows you to set a renaming pattern. For example, you can set it to automatically rename the image to whatever the title of your current note is. So the images will always have a corresponding note because they have the same name. And this makes searching images in the search bar a lot easier. QuickSwitcher++ is an improved version of Obsidian's native QuickSwitcher plugin. It allows you to do a lot of things. For example, to find files by headings instead of by file name. It searches Obsidian bookmarks. It runs Obsidian commands. It navigates to related files. If you use multiple vaults, you will love this plugin because it makes switching from vault to vault a lot easier. You can exclude folders from search, and so much more that I didn't even mention here. I definitely don't use all of the settings this plugin has to offer, but what I do use, I really like. Somehow, my most used section of this plugin is the fact that it shows me recent files, which surprised me too. But because I get distracted easily and I'm always catching myself and then circling back to whatever I was doing before I got distracted, and these recent files really help me because it gives me that visual cue, kind of similar to what the homepage provides for me, but in the quick switcher. It helps me remind myself what I was doing before I got distracted because I remember that note that I had previously opened. It sounds stupid, but it works. It has helped me more times than I can count. Remember Cursor Position is maybe the simplest plugin I use. As the name suggests, it's a plugin that remembers where you left off the last time you opened a file. This is very helpful if you switch from note to note a lot, which I do sometimes, so you don't constantly have to navigate back to where you were before. That's all it really does, and it does it well. Style Settings is a plugin that I use in combination with the Anupuchin theme. I don't know if I'm butchering that name, sorry. And it creates a somewhat cuter and more colorful look to my Obsidian. It gives you so many more options for changing your theme, adding colors. Of course, this isn't a necessity at all, but it does bring me joy, especially my rainbow folders on the left. I also really like the import section in the style settings plugin. In fact, I exported my style settings and I put them in a paste bin link in the description box of this video. So if you wanted to copy my exact Obsidian style, you can download the Anupuchin theme, the style settings plugin, and then copy everything that's in the paste bin in this import section, and your vault should look exactly like mine. If it's not your style, you can of course play around with it on your own. You don't have to do that. You can also add CSS snippets to customize your vault even further, although I personally haven't really felt the need to add those. It's important to note that not all themes support style settings, by the way. I know the Anipuchin theme does, which is what I have, and I know Blue Topaz does as well. Last but certainly not least, the Tag Wrangler plugin. Honestly, this plugin is integrated so well that I often forget it's not native to Obsidian. Tag Wrangler has so many good use cases. It allows you to create subtags using a forward slash. You can easily nest them in your list of tags and collapse every child tag under its parent tag. It also allows you to rename tags, which native Obsidian does not allow you to do. And that has helped me out majorly before. It also improves search because you can now add a tag as a requirement to your search. For example, I tag all my daily notes as hashtag daily note. So if I want to search for something specific and I only wanted to include my daily notes, I can do that. You can also create tag pages, which is a note that is linked to that specific tag. I don't personally use this option, but I've heard others have found this really helpful. Those are the 12 plugins that make my Obsidian life a lot easier. Thank you to all these wonderful developers for creating these wonderful plugins for free. I know developers often don't get paid anything or not much at all, and these are often side projects, so I did want to extend my thank you to them. There's definitely a lot more plugins that I could download and use. However, I personally try not to rely on plugins too much. Plugins are often, like I said, side projects for developers, and they don't always get maintained. Although they are open source, so others can always pick up the plugin if it's abandoned, but still. In 10 years, if Obsidian is not the hot new software anymore, we could end up with a graveyard of plugins. This is why I prefer to use plugins that make my note-taking a little bit easier and more streamlined. But if the plugin wouldn't exist anymore, it's not like my vault would, like, fall apart, you know? I also don't love, personally, plugins that add a ton of code or otherwise drastically change the contents of a note, because in my humble opinion, it's just not as future-proof for me. Anyway, that was a side tangent. Let me know if you liked this format, because this is the first time that I did a format with just a voiceover and not my disembodied hands. I'm just a disembodied voice now. So let me know if you like this format. If not, I can always change back. Just wanted to switch it up. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video if you enjoyed it. And I will see you very soon. Bye!